This is Joel Shaul with AutismTeachingStrategies.com. I would like to show you how to use this simple tool to help teach kids on the autism spectrum about reciprocity in conversation. Here's your tool. It is a toy balance. You can get these online inexpensively. This one in particular works well. It's made by Learning Resources. These are 3x5 cards. You use these as weights in the balance. And it's useful to have two different colors, one color for this side and one color for the other side. Here's how this works. You introduce it by telling the child something like this. When people talk together, they should talk back and forth. It's something like a balance. One person talks for a little bit, and then the other person talks about what the first person just said. This person might ask a question. Then this person might answer that question. This person might ask a question. And then this person might answer that question. And so it goes back and forth. One person talks, the other person talks. They take turns. It's not good if one person talks way too much. It's like they're using up all the words, and that wouldn't be fair. Also, it's not good if one person just talks and the other person just sits there and doesn't say anything, because that's not balanced either. So once you've introduced it this way, you can teach the child how to place the cards on one side or the other himself. Then you can try doing a kind of a role play demonstration, which I call the flawed adult role play. Let's say you position the balance in between you and the child, and you say, I'm going to talk to you right now, and I want you to place the cards on the balance while we talk, so we can find out whether it's a balanced conversation. So at this point, you can talk to the child about something that's not very interesting to him. Let's say you talk about the contents of your wallet, and you talk about the cards, and the AAA card, and the picture of your granny, and some slips of paper and some receipts, and then the other person, the child, isn't talking at all, or maybe just gets a little chance to talk. And so the kid picks up what a monologue or a lecture sounds like, and how it's unbalanced. Then you can continue to do other role plays that are balanced. Other ways you can do this is you can have one child operate the balance while observing two other people talk. You can also have them do this while they're looking at a video or a TV program of people talking, and they get the idea that people should talk back and forth instead of one person just talking while the other person is listening. Later, once you've established this as a visual metaphor, you can refer to it. So for example, if the child later on is talking too much about something of interest to them, instead of saying, you're talking too much, or you're being boring, you can say, remember the balance, and then that makes reference to the thing you were teaching them about earlier. You can also turn this into a gestural prompt that you do with your hands. You can have them go like this, like a balance. While people are talking, you can have the child stand behind them in a role play demonstration, and they can pretend they're the balance. They can keep track of how one person is talking and whether that person's talking a lot or a little bit. Then later on, if the child is in a situation where they're starting to talk too much, if they look at you, you can use that gestural prompt. They'll look at you, and then you're making reference to the balance, and sometimes that can work better than saying you're boring or you're talking too much or time to be quiet now. So I wish you good luck with this teaching method, which has worked well for me for years. Take care.